Good morning, students. Today we will be covering lesson 3 of your grammar book. And what's the name of the lesson? It's adjectives. Adjective, we all know. It is a word that describes about noun. If I say a beautiful rose, beautiful is describing rose. An intelligent boy, intelligent is explaining about boy. Honest person, again, honest is describing person. So these words like beautiful, intelligent and honest, these are called adjectives. This we all know, right? What are we going to cover today? We'll be covering different type of adjectives. Let's see what's the first one. It's adjective of quality. It tells about the kind or quality of the person. Now, quality can be positive also and negative also. You will ask, ma'am, how a quality can be negative? Like if I say, she is ugly girl. So what the ugly is, positive or negative quality? It's the negative quality. He is a slow learner. Then again, it's a negative quality. So sometimes it's positive or negative, but it has to be a quality. Let's say, see the examples there. He is a clever boy. Clever. Japan is a developed country. Developed. Sarah is a beautiful girl. Beautiful. My boss is an honest person. Honest. Similarly, heavy, black and intelligent. Now the words which are in red, they all are showing the quality of the noun. Like clever boy, clever is telling about boy. Developed country, developed is talking about country. So it's adjective of quality. What's next? Adjective of quantity. Now here, listen very carefully. Quantity is telling about how much amount of a noun. It is not going to tell you the exact number. It is not telling you exact number. Just go by the words that I am saying, beta. Say, for a first example, I am saying, there is not much milk in the jug. I know there is not much, but how much is the milk? It's less in quantity, but I cannot tell exactly. I need some money. Can I say how much money? Some money. For somebody, some money could be 5 rupees. For somebody, some money could be 500 rupees. It varies person to person. So some money I cannot say how much money. I have little faith in God. So can we measure the faith? Can we tell how much the faith is? We cannot measure. We cannot tell exactly how much. Similarly, the other examples are, I need some money. There is enough water. Sufficient water is there. But how much water in the tank? We cannot say here how many liters are there. It is not, the statement is not telling how much quantity of water. There is little juice. So all these words in red are adjective of quantity. Now next comes adjective of number. What it is telling? It's telling about the exact number. How many people are there? How many things are there? Okay? In quantity, we were not aware about what's the exact number. But here, it's telling exact number. She sang 5 songs on the annual function ceremony. How many songs? We can count? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 songs. I saw few boys playing there. Now you will ask me, ma'am, few is not telling the exact number of boys. But can we count boys? Boys are countable. Yes. So this becomes adjective of number. Adjective of quantity is taking consideration of uncountable nouns. But adjective of number is taking count of countable nouns. Okay? Next, most girls participated in the knitting competition. Most of the girls out of the group, most of the girls participated. We don't know the number here, but if we count the girls, girls are countable. If you count the girls, we can tell exact number. He bought many notebooks. Again, notebooks is countable. There is only one solution to this problem. Okay, I'll just go back to the previous slide. Adjective of quantity. Look here, milk, money. I'm talking about the nouns which are coming after the red colored adjective. Milk, money, faith, water, and juice. These all are uncountable nouns. We cannot count these nouns. So they fall in the category of adjective of quantity. And which we can count? Like songs, boys, girls, notebooks, solution. These come under the category of number. Now, types of adjectives or number can be divided into three. Definite, indefinite, and distributive. Now, definite word is saying it is talking about surety. We are definite about it. So, now this is again divided into two parts. Definite numeral is divided into two parts, cardinal and ordinal. Cardinal and ordinal. Now look here, this word cardinal is here. Cardinal is like 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes? And again, there is ordinal written here. Ordinal is telling about the position, 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th. Yes? So, this is divided into two parts. Cardinal and ordinal. Both are definite numerals. Example, there are 30 students. 30 cardinal. I ate 5 mangoes. 5 is again cardinal. But if I say she was the first, I'm telling about the position now. She was the first one to join the class, dance class. So that will be ordinal. Okay? Next, adjective is indefinite. There are three types of numeral adjectives. Now second is indefinite. Indefinite means which we are not definite about, which we are not sure about. Yes? Look here. Now if I say these words like some, many, few, and several, these are the words which are not giving the surety. We are not sure, we are not definite. Okay? Understand it with the help of examples. Several students. Students is countable. That's why it is adjective of number. Indefinite is a part of adjective of number. So that will fall in indefinite numeral. Many people. Again, people is countable. I bought some eggs. Eggs is again countable. Yes? So all these will fall under the category of indefinite numeral adjectives, which we can count, but the exact number we cannot say. That is indefinite numeral. Now you will ask, ma'am, what's the difference between adjective of quantity and indefinite numeral? Again, I'll say, adjective of quantity is for uncountable nouns like milk, sugar, water. But indefinite numeral adjectives are for countable nouns like students, pens, vehicles, houses, which we can count. Okay? Now the third part of adjective of number is distributive. Now, as the word say distributive, when we are distributing something, we are giving that thing to each and every person. So, you just look at the screen here. These are the words every, each, either, another, neither. These are the words which are telling about the adjective of number in a distributive way. Let's see how, with the help of example. Every student in the class stood up. Now I'm talking about every student of the class, not one or two, everyone. Yes, each one of you will get a different project. Now each is again talking about the everyone who is present there. Yes, so it's distributive. Okay, when you're talking about the individuals. Now here comes demonstrative adjective. As the word says, demonstrative, we are demonstrating something, we are representing something. Things which are near to us, we use this and these, and something which is far off is that and those. This is for singular, these is for plural. That is for singular and those is for plural. Suppose I say example, do you like this soup? Which means soup is near to me. Yes? And soup is uncountable. That's why we have used a singular adjective here. That dress looks good on you, which means the dress is a little far off. It's a single dress and it's a little far off. This way, these and those are also used. Something which is near and many in number, these puppies. And the last line, those vegetables. That means the vegetables are a little far off and many in number. Okay? Interrogative. Interrogative word tells us about interrogation. Interrogation means question answer session. Yes, when we are asking questions, that is interrogation. So words like what, which, whose, which are adjoining noun, which are coming along with noun, they are called interrogative adjective. Which book, which place, whose pen. Yes. So let's see examples. Which book is yours? Now which and book are coming together. So here which is interrogative adjective. It is talking which book. Yes. Whose car? Now again, whose is related to car and they are coming together. Interrogative adjective. Similarly, the other examples are there for you. Possessive adjective. Now possessive tells about the possession. Who is the owner of that thing? Suppose a book belongs to me. So what will I say? This is my book. But if it belongs to you, what will you say? Sorry, what will I say? This is your book. Yes? And if a book belongs to a girl, what will you say? It's her book. And if it belongs to a boy, it's his book. So the words like my, your, his or her, are, their, they are telling who is the owner of that thing or things, who actually it belongs to. Yes, this is my house, so which means this house belongs to me. His car is parked outside. So this car is talking about a boy or a man. This car belongs to a boy or man. It's parked outside. Our work is almost done. So we're talking about a group where you and I are included together as a group. So our work is almost done. Her books are interesting. The books are related to a girl. Emphasizing adjective. Emphasizing means when you are stressing on something. When I'm putting stress, I'm emphasizing with the strong feelings. That's called emphasizing adjectives. You should take your own car to the function. I could have said like you should take your car to the function. But if I'm saying your own car, so I'm emphasizing that you have to take your own car. He has his own house in Delhi. So this word own is emphasizing adjective. It happened before my eyes. This is also true. But if I want to emphasize, I'll say it happened before my very eyes. So such words like own and very are emphasizing adjective. There are other examples as well. Now we have to find out how to make adjectives from nouns. Yes, we can make adjectives from nouns like girl. It's a noun, common noun. What is the adjective? Girlish. Danger. Danger is abstract noun. So what is the adjective? Dangerous. Trouble. Again, it's a abstract noun. Yes, so troublesome. Similarly, there are other nouns and adjectives. So adjectives are formed from nouns as well. We'll just go through these examples. Putting it in the sentence, the weather is getting stormy in Atlantic Ocean. Now this word stormy has been derived from storm. Yes, storm is a common noun. So it is being derived from storm and it's now made into adjective. It is stormy is describing about weather, stormy weather. Yes, my sister's wedding dress is golden in color. So this word golden has come from gold. Yes, it's a material noun. So now this word golden is describing dress. So it's an adjective. Such way we can make adjectives from nouns. Now let's see how to make adjectives from verbs. Verbs are action words. Enjoy, enjoyable. Hate, hateful. Help, helpful. Laugh, laughable. Such way we can make the other adjectives also from the verbs. Now let's see how to put them in sentences. Our teacher is very helpful in our studies. Now which is the verb here? Any guesses? Help. Very nice. Now, going to my grandparents' house is always an enjoyable experience. Which is the word here? Verb? Enjoy. So we can use these words. Helpful is talking about teacher and enjoyable is talking about experience. So these both are adjectives. Now we can make adjectives out of adjectives, you know. Let's see how. Suppose I say threesome, easy, easier, green, greenish. Yes, if I say the grass is green, it is talking about grass. Green is talking about grass. It is an adjective. But if I say the lawn appears to be more greenish than always, then again greenish is also adjective. Okay, let's see example. My sister is funnier than me. If I say my sister is funny, it's an adjective. Funny is describing about sister. But if I'm saying my sister is funnier than me, then this is also describing the sister. The sky was appearing a little red. If I say little red, not reddish, a little red. So it is an adjective, it is describing sky. But similarly, reddish is also describing the sky. So we can make adjectives from the adjectives, right? So what all we can make adjectives from? Nouns, verbs and adjectives. I believe students, now we are pretty clear about the types of adjectives and how to form adjectives from noun, verb and adjectives. Just go through this video once again, and if you feel there is something which you have not understood, please do ask me a question in your online class. Okay? Just take care of yourself and keep smiling. Thank you, everyone.